countries have long been inextricably linked. But for more than a year now, New Zealand has been out of reach. No more. Like a scene from a classic movie, there were plenty of tearful reunions today. Mothers and daughters, siblings, friends and lovers meeting once again. Even new grandparents greeting grandkids for the first time.
I've been waiting so long, it's just fantastic.
Stories like Shelley Kenobi Harris and her two daughters playing out across Australia. Kiwis now finally allowed to head back home. Ms. Kenobi Harris from Brisbane has missed three funerals while the borders were closed, including her father's, making this reunion with her mother Sue in Auckland today bittersweet.
Amazing to go through the airport calmly with no paperwork and, yeah, just like freedom to see my family.
We're so excited. We've been wanting Shelley home for a long time.
Since borders began closing in early 2020, the well-travelled path between New Zealand and Australia has been all but deserted. Today, with the green light from the New Zealand authorities, passports were dusted off.
I'm feeling really, really excited.
And bags checked in.
It's nearly 400 days since you could travel quarantine-free, and now we've got this huge buzz at the airport. Better be home
soon. Airports marking the occasion with live music in Sydney and a dance performance in Melbourne. And after a quick photo at the gate, hundreds of passengers departed Australia for the other side of the ditch. On the three-hour journey over the Tasman, more stories of separation.
My dad has never met him before, so he's very excited to meet his little grandson. The first time he's been on a plane and first time I've travelled as a mum.
One dad, already overwhelmed by emotion, finally able to see his two children again.
I've gotten really upset. Sorry. It's so good.
Travellers arriving in New Zealand from Australia are shuttled through what's called the Green Zone, separate from other international arrivals who still have to quarantine.
It's just unbelievable. It feels surreal.
This moment in time here is really the next step in our recovery.
Today, bringing the first glimmer of hope for the tourism and aviation industries so badly hit by the pandemic.
Well, it's a win-win for Australia and New Zealand, and I think this is going to be very important for the tourism and travel industry.
A collective sigh of relief and tears of joy. After a long wait, the land of the long white cloud is back in business.